A paintbrush, huh?
Okay.
A paintbrush like that? That's a pretty nice paintbrush. That's what they call a sable brush. I don't usually buy paintbrushes that nice because I'm not really good with them. That's a paintbrush, isn't it? You two can hold the paintbrush. Does that look like a paintbrush too? This is what I call my hammer. That's a paintbrush that's been used so much that it's stiff as a rock. But there are times when you're painting that you want a paintbrush that doesn't give much. You use it more like a stick than a brush. There's a different kind of paintbrush. And there's another paintbrush. They're all different sizes, aren't they? All different shapes. You want one? Okay, Ed. Is that a paintbrush? Well, look at that. Show that. Well, hold it up and let everybody see that. Is that a paintbrush? Hold it up.
No.
What is that? Be careful with that, because that's actually sharp. You know what they call that? It's a painting knife.
It's paper.
Well, I don't think you can call it that, but it's a painting knife. You move paint around like this. Instead of using a brush, you're using a painting knife. What's this?
Peel.
What's that look like? Does your mom have one of those in the kitchen?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a ladle, isn't it?
It's for heat.
Well, you think so, but do you know you can paint with that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. I
didn't know that. There's a very famous artist that's been gone for many, many years. But his name was Jackson Pollock. Now Jackson Pollock wasn't the best fellow to think of as to emulating, but Jackson Pollock is one of my inspirations when I paint. And one of the things that Pollock used the most to paint with was ladles or tin cups, things like that. He's pouring paint instead of using a brush. So the moral of the story is when God's making his creation, God's an artist too, isn't he? Hold the handle, don't grab the rest of that. God's an artist too, and when God's doing his creation, you know, we might think that he's going to use the pretty people and the nice people and all the normal people. I'm not sure who those people are. Like this. This is an expensive brush. But God doesn't do that. God uses ordinary people. Let me see that other one. Let me see that one. That's one of my favorite brushes. I need that one back. He uses this one's a little better brush, but still a pretty ordinary brush. God will use a very inexpensive brush that you buy for a few cents at the Home Depot or someplace. And God will use a very old, very weathered and beaten up and had a better day brush paint as well. Or God will use something like this that you wouldn't first look at and think to be something you can create with. But some knife paintings are some of the most incredible paintings that are out there. Now where did my ladle go?
Yeah.
Oh, I have it. Did you ever lose something that was right in front of you? I just did that. And God can also use the most unexpected, something you would never guess, to create something beautiful. The least likely of all. I've talked about that before. That's oftentimes, actually most of the time, the people that God wants to use. Okay? So never think that you're not somebody that God can use. God can use everybody. Yeah, absolutely. Right? All right, let's say a quick prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you for all the so many different people that you use in this world to create your magnificent creation and this place that we live in and that you provide for us. Lord, so many different souls, so many different backgrounds, so many different talents all blended together to create a beautiful painting. We pray all this in your loving and graceful name. Amen. Thank you all so much, okay? Good to see you. Come back next Sunday.